Okay, I think I'm recording. But I'm shooting this at 4K. I might have tried this before. It's severely... limits your capacity from like 5 hours to 2.5 or something on the same memory card that unless there's a really big benefit, and I really don't think there's gonna be, I probably won't use this on a regular basis, at least on more lengthy rides. This is only about a 30-minute ride, if it's even that long. I'm actually heading over to a motorcycle dealer. There's a bike there that I'm semi-interested in, and was different, eh? But anyway, the only way to find out if I'm interested in it is to go over and actually get some numbers. This bike has been wonderful, but it is 22 years old at this point, and I'm thinking it's going to probably need some work. And if I'm going to do some work on it, then I'd like to get the engine built a little bit, probably get cams, and try to increase the horsepower. But what I'm really trying to find out at this point is what the value of this bike is. I don't want to put more money into the bike than it's worth, but by the same token, at this point, I don't really have to put any money into this bike. So, anyhow, that's what I'm doing. I've filmed this route before, probably at a different time of day, though, and probably not in 4K. So, this might prove interesting just to see the quality of it. Tied up on the telephone this morning between trying to schedule some medical tests I need in a few months and some other stuff for the house. So I really wanted to leave her on 10 o'clock, and I think it's closer to noon at this point. I know it's no excuse. I don't have any gear on today other than my riding boots. It's supposed to be very humid and be up into the mid to upper 80s today, so I figured I'd be a dumbass and not put any gear on. I do have a helmet on. Man, you hit pockets of hot air for, you know, for a while it feels comfortable, then all of a sudden the heat just blasts you. Dropping down here into lovely McKeesport. Destiny Pike Fire Department. No idea what they'd be doing here. They're from West Virginia, it says. But here they are. Looks like they're digging over there for something. Don't know what. Think I'm still taping. Or recording, rather. Not taping. Thought we'd get through that one, but we didn't. I get a little bit of air in this helmet anyway. It was pretty quick. Seems like the last light was way longer than that. Yeah, it's hot out here. Anyway, the bike I'm looking at, if they still have it, is a 2020, I think, Triumph Speed Twin, which is basically a Thruxton with a more relaxed riding position. From what I understand, it has 99 horsepower or 90-some horsepower and 90-some foot-pounds of torque, or give or take. I'm not a big statistics individual, but it looks pretty neat, and it doesn't seem overly expensive. Brother-in-law has a Triumph bobber that he truly enjoys. I don't think he's had any issues with it, so that's what I'm thinking. You never know. Like I said, I have no idea what the motorcycle I'm riding is worth, mainly because of its age. In the market with COVID, supposedly increasing the value of used motorcycles. Forgot what I was doing. More concerned about talking. But these things happen. Now I'm heading on Route 30 East. I think I'm in North Versailles. Biggest concern with this motorcycle is, you know, around town and what I'm doing like today, it's fine and dandy. It's nothing wrong with it. But you get on a highway and you want to cruise at a, you know, say 80, 85, 90. It's not real happy up there. Nothing like missing my turn. Boy, that came up quick. kind of a shame, but all the motorcycle shops in our area have pretty much closed. There's a few, but the few that are left, at least this year, have like zero inventory. I mean, not zero, maybe three bikes, maybe six bikes. I mean, not like back in the day when I was riding all the time, that did have tons of bikes. Not anymore. So here we are. I'm shutting her off now.